you said that the Holy Scriptures is how many books? 73, 46 in the Old Testament, 27 in the New Testament. The 46 is 39 plus 7. The 39 is 5 books of Moses, 12 historical books, 5 poetic books, 5 major prophets, and 12 minor prophets. And 7 deuterocanonical books. So we are trying to focus on the major theme of every book. And what we are saying is Heils Geschichte. In German, it means history of salvation. To see our Lord Jesus Christ in every book in the Holy Bible. I will try to say it and try to focus with me, please. And try within yourself to say it. Genesis, in the book of Genesis, we see our Lord Jesus as the seed of the women. The seed of the women. In Exodus, our Lord Jesus is the Passover lamb. In Leviticus, our Lord Jesus is the atoning sacrifice. In Numbers, our Lord Jesus is the smitten rock. In Deuteronomy, our Lord Jesus is the faithful prophet. This is the 5 books of Moses. Pentateuch, the law, the Torah. Okay? I say the 5 books of Moses again. Genesis, talking about the beginnings. God is the creator because he is Pantocrator, Almighty. Exodus is the book of redemption. God is the savior or the redeemer because he is merciful. Leviticus, how to worship. God is the sanctifier because he is holy. Numbers, wandering. God is the sustainer. He gives them manna. He gives them the water. He directs them. He is the sustainer because he is loving. Deuteronomy, the renewal of the covenant. God is the rewarder because he is just. When we talked about God is merciful, God is also just. 12 historical books. We see our Lord Jesus in the book of Joshua, the commander of the Lord. In Judges, he is the divine deliverer. In Ruth, he is the redeemer, kinsman. Boaz is a type of him. First Samuel, our Lord is the anointed one. The word anointed one means Christ, the Messiah. Second Samuel, our Lord is the son of David, as in 2 Samuel chapter 7. First and second Kings, our Lord is the coming king. First and second Chronicles, our Lord is the builder of the temple. And in John 2, he told them, destroy this temple, and in 3 days, I will raise it again. So first and second Chronicles, our Lord is the builder of the temple. Ezra, our Lord Jesus, is the restorer of the temple after they destroyed it at the time of Nebuchadnezzar. Our Lord not only the restorer of the temple, but in Nehemiah, he is the restorer of the nation. He is not only the restorer of the nation, but in Esther, he is the preserver of the nation. Because Haman wants to kill all of them, and he preserved them. We are done with that, with the historic. Five, poetic. Job. Our Lord Jesus is the living redeemer. Job said this, قال ولي حي. Psalms, our Lord is the praise of Israel. Proverbs, our Lord is the wisdom. St. Paul said it in 1 Corinthians chapter 1, verse 24. Christ is the wisdom of the power of God and the wisdom of God. Ecclesiastes, our Lord is the great teacher. In Song of Songs, our Lord is the fairest among 10,000s. Mu'allam bayna ribwa. Fairest among 10,000s. We are done with the five poetic, but we said it. Job is the school of discipline. Psalms is the school of prayer. Proverbs is the school of life. Ecclesiastes, all is vain. Song of Solomon, love between God and his people. Five major prophets. Isaiah, I see our Lord Jesus the suffering servant. Isaiah 53. Jeremiah, our Lord is the maker of the New Testament. Jeremiah, what is the reference? 31:31. Lamentation, our Lord is the man of sorrow. Ezekiel, our Lord Jesus is the glory of God. The book of Daniel, our Lord is the coming Messiah. We are done with the five poetic, five major prophets, 12 minor prophets. Hosea, our Lord is the lover of the unfaithful. Joel, hope of Israel. Our Lord is the hope of Israel. Amos, our Lord is the husbandman, the vine. That is, he said, I'm the vine and my father is the vine dresser in the Gospel of St. John, chapter 50. Obadiah, salvation of Israel, savior of Israel. Jonah, our Lord Jesus is the resurrected one. Micah, the ruler or the governor of Israel. Micah 5:2. Nahum, the discipliner. Habakkuk, the Holy God. Zephaniah, the King of Israel. Haggai, the desire of the nations, Mushtahal Umam. Zechariah, the branch of righteousness. Our Lord Jesus Christ, the branch of righteousness. And I told you the word branch in Hebrew is Nazarene. and Malachi, our Lord, as the Son of Righteousness. This is how we see our Lord Jesus Christ in every book in the Old Testament. We started last week to talk about the book of Genesis. Reviews. The book of Genesis, how many chapters? 50. 1 and 2 is the creation. 3 is the sin of Adam and Eve. 4 and 5, the first murder when Cain killed his brother Abel. 6, 7, 8, the flood. 9, the promise to Noah. 10, the chronology, genealogy of Noah. 11, the Tower of Babel. 12, 24, our father Abraham. 25, 26, Isaac. 27, 37, Jacob and Esau. 37 to 50, sons of Jacob, especially Joseph. We started to talk also about the 7 days of creation. We said, this is the last slide. We said it. Day one, God created the light. Day two, sea and atmosphere. Day three, earth and vegetation. Day four, parallel to light, sun, moon, and the stars. Fifth, what is in the sea? Sea creature. What is in the atmosphere? Birds. This is earth and vegetation. What is on earth? Animal and animals. And day seven, God rested. I told you, St. Basil wrote a book, and St. Ambrose of Milan wrote a book, and it is called Hexameron. St. Basil wrote Hexameron, and St. Ambrose wrote Hexameron. If any one of you interested in the Hexameron, to give me a USB flash drive to write his name, and to give it to me, and I will give him the file. The book of Hexameron.
What is the book of Hexameron?
7 days of creation.
How big is it? How many pages?
Hexameron is around 300.
300?
Yeah, I believe, yeah. About it. So, God said, so God created the world by His word. St. John the Beloved, in the Gospel of St. John, he said, the Word was in the beginning, the Word was with God, the Word was with God. Everything created by the Word, by the Logos. God said 6 times, 6 days, God said. And God did. God said, God did. And God evaluated. I told you every day he says, it is good. And when he created man, he said, it is very good. But only once, I told you last week, he said, it is not good for Adam to be alone. It was good. So the creation is good. Corrupted by sin. And God blessed. God blessed them. And the word bless, it is 330 times in the Bible. God said, God did, God evaluated, and God bless. And you take, because you are children of God, you do sin. you do and you say and you evaluate what you are doing. And to bless, not to curse. So it is not just a knowledge, information, but I need to apply it in my life, and you need to apply it in your life. The first verse in the Holy Scripture, it has a lot of doctrine, of dogma. See what we learn from the first verse. In the beginning, God. This is the first part in the first verse. In the beginning, God. في البدء كان الله. In the beginning, God. Is this denied? Atheism. Is this who denying God? No, the أول حد في الكتاب. Denied polytheism, who believe in many gods, those who deny existence of God, and those who believe in many gods, like Mormon, like Buddhism, Hinduism. Those who believe in two gods, God of good and the God of evil. This is doles. So, in the beginning, God. In the beginning, God created. This denied evolution. Evolution is theory. And if it is a part of the evolution is right in certain things, it is used by God. It doesn't mean that creation start from there is no designer, no creator, no God. Because nobody can bring any materials to bring metal or anything and to put it in a box and to start shaking it for 6 months and to give you a watch or a computer. Till now they don't know what is the living, how the living cell started. Nobody in the lab can create a living cell. No one. So, and they denied fatalism. That the creature start by chance. Nothing it happens by chance. They tell a story about a man. They asked him to come and to give a lecture about the existence of God and against atheism. And he was many of his audience. They were atheists. And he came late to the lecture. And they asked him, why you didn't keep your promise and to come on time? And they told them, I waited till I made some wood with my hands. And I make a boot and I put it and till I come here. Then, crazy how you made wood with your hands and how you made a boat and you put it on the street. And you told them, you are thinking about the world as created from nothing. You make a big deal that I made a boat. In the beginning, God created the heaven and the earth. This is the first verse. This denies pantheism. Pantheism is this is who say that the heaven and the earth are eternal, has no beginning. And it denies materialism. The materials exist by itself. And it denies eternity of matter. God, in the beginning, God is Elohim. Elohim, this denies monarchianism. Monarchianism is here. From it came the Islam. Monarchianism.
Elohim.
Elohim is God. Im is plural. Because God is Trinity. Because they say that God is one hypostasis. One person, only one person. And this is, it is not. Because if God is one hypostasis, it means that he was forced to create other creature because he had no love. Or if he had love, it is idle, not working. Till he create. So God is Elohim. And this just to show you very simple. This is, it is done by NASA. They took $200 million image of the sun. And this is to show you how God is wise. And if the earth comes too close to the sun, will be burned. And if it goes too farther, it will be freezing. And think about it, the laws of nature, the gravity. Think about how God created the planets, the universes, and there is certain planets, if you put the sun in the center and the earth in its space distance from the sun, both of them can fit inside this one planet. You know the distance between the earth and the sun? You can put the sun in the center of this planet and the earth to go around with the same distance inside this planet. And billions of planets. Think about the creature. When you think about the sea creatures or the birds or the human beings, those who study the physiology of the eye or the brain, to find that this is, God is great, God is wise, God is powerful. There are four basic questions common to every individual. Its answers is in the Holy Bible. Who am I? Where did I come from? Why am I here? Where am I going when I die? This is fundamental, basics question. And I told you, do you remember the story of the hermit? I say it again. A man went to a hermit and he asked him three questions. How can I believe in God and I don't see him? And number two, you say that Satan, the devil, was created from fire and he will suffer by fire. And the third, everything is according to its fate. Qadariya. And this hermit, he brought tuba, a stone, but it is from dust. And he hit him. So he took him to the court, to the judge. And he told the judge, I asked this hermit three questions and he hit me. And the judge told the hermit, why did you do this? And he said, I answered these questions. How you answer this question? He said that, first question, how I can believe in God and I don't see him? He said that when I hit him, it was painful. Let him to show me the pain. The second one, he said, how Satan is created from fire and suffered by fire. How he is created from dust and suffered by something from dust. And the third question, if everything according to its fate, his fate to take a hit. So he answered his questions with a hit and break. So, who am I? Where did I come from? Why am I here? Because deviating from the goal which God assigned to me is a sin. The word sin in Greek, it is hamartia. Hamartia means missing the mark. When I deviate from the goal which God assigned to me, this is sin. Is it clear? Some consequences of sin. After the sin of Adam and Eve, what is the consequence? Death. What kind of death? Physical death. Spiritual death. God told Adam, when you ate from the tree of the knowledge of good and evil, you will die. He died right away. First, he died spiritually. And he died physically. He died spiritual. Spiritual death is more dangerous than physical death. You see, many people are physically living, but spiritually dead. And our Lord Jesus, when he talked about the prodigal son, is talking about him as dead. The prodigal son died spiritually. Because God is life. He said, I am the resurrection and the life. The Gospel of St. John, chapter 11. When we are away from him, we are dead. And the, St. Paul said in his epistle to Ephesians chapter 2, you were dead. You were dead. And the, in the book of Revelation chapter 3, he said to the angel of the church, you say that you have name that you are living, but you are dead. Nakedness, and this is nakedness from the glory of God. This is why our Lord crucified the naked, to cover us. Curse. Curse is repeated many times in the book of Genesis. In the book of Revelation says, curse will not be anymore. Toil. He told him that you will eat your bread with toil and the sweat, with your sweat. You will eat your bread, fear. Adam tried to hide from God, hiding our deeds, what we are doing. Blame game. Did you eat? He said, Eve. Why Eve did you eat? She said, the serpent. This, it happens even between husband and wife. Blame game. Everyone to blame the other. Alien from God, away from God. I will tell you fastly, because 2 weeks and we will start the whole week. Our Lord Jesus Christ, he did the opposite of this, what had happened with Adam. Adam, he is a man and he wants to eat from the tree to become like a God. Our Lord Jesus is God and became man, son of man. Adam stretched his hand and he took from the tree. Our Lord stretched his hand and nailed. Adam, he ate from the tree. Our Lord from the tree, they made a cross. Adam, he ate from the fruit and it is sweet. Our Lord on the cross, he drank vinegar. Adam, God told him, the earth will give you thorns. They took the thorns and made it
crown
for our Lord. Adam, he said that with your sweat, and our Lord in the Gospel of St. Luke chapter 22, his sweat dripping blood. God called Adam, Adam, Adam. Our Lord on the cross, he said, my God, my God. And Adam, when he did sin, he became naked. Our Lord was crucified naked. And Adam, this is the curse, cursed the earth. Our Lord Jesus became a curse. Galatians chapter 3, verse 13. He became a curse because it is written in the law that cursed the one was hung in the tree. ملعون من يعلق على خشبة. So our Lord Jesus, Adam was cast away from paradise. Our Lord on the cross, he opened the paradise when he said to the thief, assuredly I say to you, today you will be with me in paradise. Adam was in the garden and he, when he was tempted, failed. Our Lord was in the desert, in the wilderness, and when he was tempted, was victorious. Adam was satisfied, and he did sin. Our Lord was hungry, and he conquered the Satan. Adam was bitten by the serpent. Our Lord crushed the head of the serpent. He crushed the head of the serpent. So, what Adam failed, our Lord Jesus, he did the opposite to return back, to give us the salvation. This is why St. Paul said in Romans chapter 8, Adam is the type of the one who comes. Adam الذي هو مثال الآتي. Adam is a type of our Lord. This why we call our Lord Jesus the last Adam. This why our Lord Jesus was incarnated to save us. Because we did sin against God. We corrupted the image and the likeness, and he came to earth to give us, to return back to the incorruption, to return us back to the incorruption. This is why God prevented Adam from eating from the tree of life. Because our Lord Jesus wants to return the image and the likeness back, and to give us the authority to eat from the tree of life. ecological crisis because of sin, because this, we face this with the children especially. They ask us, why God allows earthquakes? Why there is hurricanes? Why there is diseases? Why we see children handicaps? Why we see children and they died in young age? This is because of sin. And the saints, the holy men of God, always they say this. Remember this three chapters. Ezra chapter 9. What is after Ezra? Nehemiah chapter 9. And Daniel chapter 9. Ezra, Nehemiah, Daniel chapter 9. And those three chapters, they say, this is because of our sins. Everything is happening with us is because of our sins. Let me say it in this way, as St. Augustine said it. Everything you have is from God except one, except sin. Everything you have is from God except sin. First Adam. Adam lived 930 years. Enoch. Enoch is number 7. He lived 365. Let me tell you briefly about Enoch. Enoch, his life is concluded in one verse. In Arabic we say it, حكاية في آية. A story in one verse. Adam, Enoch, at age 65, he started to live with God, to walk with God. And he walked with God for 300 years. So God told him, Enoch, come with me. And God took him to heaven, transferred him to heaven. So he didn't die. Who else didn't die?
Elijah.
Your name, please?
Michael.
Come, Michael, please. Next to me. Welcome. So you see us as what numbers?
11.
Mm-hmm. Enoch and Elijah. Revelation 11.
Oh,
thank you, Mike. Revelation chapter 11. Enoch and Elijah. They will come back. And the Antichrist will kill them. And nobody will dare to bury them. After 3 days, they will rise again and ascend to heaven. But the people, they will ridicule them, and they send the gifts to each other because they were killed. Look to this, please. Adam, our father Abraham, and our Lord Jesus, the incarnation, the birth of our Lord Jesus. Adam, Abraham. In the middle, Enoch. Abraham, incarnation of our Lord. In the middle, Elijah. So, Adam, Enoch, Abraham, Elijah, our Lord Jesus Christ. Okay? So this is Enoch. Methuselah. This is the longest life on earth, Methuselah. When we meet our father, the bishop, when he comes to the church and we receive him with a hymn, we we pray saying, God give you the life of Esau Saul. Let me tell you this. The word meso sala, when this is the meaning of the word meso sala, when he dies, comes. In the year meso sala dies, the flood came. When meso sala died, the flood came. Noah, 950 years, 10th from Adam. He is 8th. Noah, 8th, 7th from Adam. Shem. Noah had three children, Shem, Ham, and Japheth. Their genealogy in Genesis 10. Shem is the father of Arab and Jews. Ham is the father of Africans. Japheth is the father of the Europeans. If you read Genesis 10, you will find the 70 nations. Shem. Eber, they say that Hebrew, maybe some of the theorists, they call them Hebrews because of this man, Eber, the father of the Jews, Aber. This is why they call them Ibraniyin. Our father Abraham. You see the years, 600, 400, 175.
Less.
Yes.
Why?
Many reasons. They said that man lived too much, so he did too many sins. It is written in the book of Genesis that let us make his age is 120. The average, 120. And in the book of Psalms, they make the average year 80. At our time, it was 55, increased. So, what is the average now?
Depending on where you are. In Africa, it's about 56 in Africa.
Yeah, here in United.
About 75.
75? You give us hope. Isaac, Jacob, one for yourself. Joseph, 110 years.
110, I think.
Yes.
I have a question. It might sound ridiculous, but please forgive me.
No.
Are there two Enochs in Genesis? Because look at Cain. Cain's line had Enos, and then there was an Enoch down the line, and then Lamech, and then in the line of Seth, who is the third child of Adam and Eve, there's also an Enoch and a Lamech and an Enos. One was from Cain's line, and another from the line of Seth.
They are line, they came from Seth, not from Cain. Because you have, let me show you this. Because we are trying to talk briefly I don't talk in details because it takes a longer time. Cain, Enoch, Aaron.
So is it two Lamechs?
Yes, yes. Two Lamech and the two Enos. Two of them. And let me show you because we come to this one. Is this is the time of their death from of death as to world history? And this is the year of the flood. Genesis 5. You know that they were overlapping. It means that the birth of Noah here and the death of Adam here. It means that Noah attended at the time of Seth, almost, and Enosh, Noah and Enoch. So you see that our father Abraham, not too far from someone like Methuselah or Enoch, not too far. Overlapping.
Did the people that were existing before Noah, did they go with him in the ark or?
No.
How did they?
No, لأنه أنت بتتكلم على الارك. They already died.
Okay, so the ark was towards the end of Noah's life?
Yeah. After 600 in his life.
But he was not young when he built the ark.
Yes.
But an old man.
But because he lived 900 something, so it means that in his youth.
So the person that's right before him, I mean, they have almost the same lifespan. So he must have lived like 300 years with him in the ark or something?
No. هو طايمه كان already died. Noah, only Noah, his wife, his three children and their wives. So just only six people entered the ark. And I told you the organizing in the church, it is like the Noah's Ark, according to the sincere of Jesus. Mm-hmm. This is the timeline. We'll turn you back to... Is this Noah's Ark? Noah's Ark is a soccer playground. It's a site. Meaning of names. This is etymology. Adam means a man. Seth means appointed. Enosh, mortal. Kenan, sorrow. Mahlael, the blessed God. El is God. Jared shall come down. Enoch, teaching. Methuselah, his death shall bring the flood. Lamech, despairing. Noah, rest or comfort. I have a book. It has about 150 pages. Meaning of names, like a dictionary, but it is in Arabic. مشكات الطلاب في حل مشكلات الكتاب. And it is like this. This one of its pages. The word and its meaning, the word and its meaning. Genesis chapter 12-24. 1 and 2 creation, 3 the sin of Adam and Eve, 4 and 5 the first murder, 6, 7, and 8 the flood, 9 the promise to Noah, 10 the chronology, genealogy of Noah, 11 Tower of Babel, 12-24 our father Abraham, 25-26 Isaac, 27-37 Jacob and Esau, 37-50 sons of Jacob, especially Joseph. God willing, next week we will start with our father Abraham from 12-24, and glory be to God forever and ever.